I didn't prepare questions. This is not a very good interview. Hey guys, Joey from Immortals here at Houston Finals with David. How are you liking the event so far?
I'm enjoying it a bunch. I saw Steve earlier, now I'm meeting you, so this is awesome.
Yeah. Is this your first live event?
No, I was at St. Louis.
Oh, okay. So I'm assuming Houston local?
No, I'm actually living in Kentucky right now.
Wait, really?
You're
coming down this far for finals?
14-hour drive.
All right, so obviously you're supporting Team Liquid.
Yes.
I assume you think Team Liquid's going to win.
Yeah, I'm hoping for a 5-game series, though, even though, like, a 3-0 would be nice, but 5 games would just be fun.
So do you want a quick 3-0 today so it's easy to finals, or you want the full 10-game bloodbath?
So 5 games today, because I actually like EG, and then 3-0 tomorrow.
I'm assuming a EG fan or what?
Yeah, just a little bit, you know, might just be slightly biased. I actually even saw Peter Dunn outside when we were coming in.
Did he say hi to you?
I said hi. I don't know if he recognized who I was.
Peter Dunn, what are we doing?
He was dealing with some, you know, very important coach stuff, I'm sure, before the games today. They're going to be very well prepped, you know. I am slightly biased. I'm hoping for that EG win, hoping that my boys come through.
Okay, so what are you predicting the score?
You know, I think it's going to be tough, you know, and I want 5 games. So I want the 3-2, but I want EG to come up with the upset. I think it'd be really sick. I think a lot of NA fans would be super hyped to see it.
Yeah.
So.
Honestly, as a live viewing fan, always a 5-game series is always the best, no matter what team you're supporting. So 3-2 tomorrow as well then?
3-2 tomorrow as well. You know, I do think 100 Thieves look really, really strong. You know, they're doing some really great stuff, so it's going to be tough for whoever has to face them tomorrow, but give me 5 games.
Yeah, Blizzard's been playing quite well recently. So how do you like the live event?
I mean, it's awesome, so crazy. Literally the second we walked in the door, I saw like 15 people who I knew. It's awesome just walking around, meeting you.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure I'll see like tons more people today like this, more people tonight, so. There's nothing quite like it, you know, because I got to go to some live events way back, because, you know, been playing for a while, and, you know, missing out on all this stuff, it just hurts so much, so to be back, you know, I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Yeah. Hey guys, Joey here at Houston Finals with Nick. How are you enjoying the event so far?
I'm enjoying it really well. This is my first, full-time event since Detroit 2 years ago. When we came in, and you look at, like, the ground level, and you see, like, whoa, this is massive. And then you look up and there's like 50 other sections and everything. Like, all the fans are here having a blast. It's awesome. The energy is sick. And I hope we get like 10 games this weekend.
And how do you think NA is going to do this year?
I'm going to say the fact that China's playing on 30 ping and everyone else is a little bit in our favor this year, possibly.
Yeah. Would you say that maybe it's not in favor that China gets to play the entire tournament on 30 ping, whereas NA has to swap between?
Well, so is that what it is? I thought they were going to level it out the whole time.
I'm not actually sure. Okay. I'm not very informed, but that's what I thought. I wasn't 100%.
Look, they should be happy to be there. We were in finals. We've done that twice.
Yeah.
I don't think NA gets any more bonus points for getting to MSI finals and just getting smashed anymore. So. Do I think they're going to beat T1? No. I do think we could possibly make it to the finals again. RNG, I mean, those games aren't pretty. that RNG top esports series was not pretty. So I think we'll maybe be able to surprise this year.
Yeah, I was watching game 5, but the Chinese team still looked pretty good. T1's looking pretty hot. NA or EU, which one's doing better?
NA. NA definitely over EU.
Okay. NA definitely over EU.
You heard that, we're gonna smash them. It's gonna be easy, it's not even gonna be close. He said it first.
Yep. This is my first time actually being at an LCS final event, so honestly, it blows my mind. Cause I have Tyler 1 behind me. I got to take a picture of him, not with him, sad days. We got to see some really cool stuff, the trophies, all the stage setups. It's a pretty nice time.
Yeah, I mean, I'm happy to be here. It's always good to go out to live events again after everything that happened with COVID. Great time being here. Should be some good games in the future.
Mad Magical, Alec Battery, and Spax. How are you guys liking the event so far?
So far, so good. Just vibing, chilling, you know?
We're trolling in here. We're getting everything we need.
Yeah, man. I ate a pretzel. It was a really good pretzel.
Would you say that the pretzel was overpriced?
Yes.
No comment.
We got to do better, guys. All right, so.
You didn't even pay for the pretzel.
Oh, there's a story. Big drama right now, okay, but moving on, who do you guys think is going to win finals?
I'm controversial. I'm going with EG 3-2.
Oh, wow. Okay, I'll just take Team Liquid. That's free. I'll do 100 Thieves.
Wow, okay.
It's a big surprise. The guy wearing the TL jersey decided to vote for 100 Thieves.
Don't Ayla, I'm sorry. Ayla's not playing. If Ayla plays, then he wins.
There's always a chance.
Yeah.
You never know, honestly.
Did they bring him as a sub?
They did bring Ayla as a sub. Ayla could play.
I mean, look, if Joey gets to play MSI, then, like, it's possible. Ayla's, it's possible.
And that was the first time MSI has been mentioned. We'll be putting a counter below for every time it's mentioned in an interview.
All right, do I just now start saying MSI the whole time? Like, you know, MSI is going to be cool. We got MSI coming up in, like, a couple weeks. It's just, we're seeing how MSI will play out with the winners here and how well they'll do internationally at MSI.
Okay, speaking of, do you guys think that whatever team we send, or actually, who do you think would do the best job at MSI? Of the three teams going. Maybe not the winner, because I actually think that the person who will win NA is not actually the team that will be the best at MSI. I don't know if you guys feel the same.
No, I actually do. I was literally gonna be like, no comment. It's like, I'm right there with you.
Yeah, okay, actually that's a pretty good point. I would say, obviously I think the favorites is if we bring TL, like everybody's expecting them to do very well, but I do agree. I think if we're gonna put anybody, it might be like 100 Thieves who might do pretty well internationally.
I think it's probably 100 Thieves too. Kuhi plays the best at MSI, so I mean, he can do it again. I believe in him.
Hey, this is Ujelly from Immortals, and I'm reporting here from LCS Houston Finals. I'm here with Joey. How are you doing today?
Wish I was a better interviewer. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How did you enjoy the games? Were you rooting for EG or Team Liquid?
Honestly, I wanted TL to win, but after seeing the Danny Pentakill, I just want EG to go to MSI.
Yeah, they actually 3-0. That was really exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, as a fellow pro player, do you see yourself going on that stage in the future?
Well, I've been on the stage as a sub, and it was always like really inspiring, so I hope one day I can make it there.
Wow, that's really great. I'm looking forward to see you up there in the future. That would be great. Anyway, we're going to wrap up this interview. I don't know what else to say.
Guys, Joey at Houston Finals with Cubby. How are you liking the event so far?
I just got in. There's like this huge line for T1. I'm hoping that like because I casted for him, I get to cut. You know, that's really the only reason I came.
Are you a big T1 fan?
I mean, I have to be. Discount code Alpha, right?
I mean, yeah. You heard it here first. So who do you think is going to win?
I'm a little bit biased towards EG. I think that their playmaking is a lot of fun. And the fact that like, you know, Jojo Pyeon is just who he is. I'm a big JoJo fan, so I got to root for the NA talent, you know?
You know, actually, a lot of people are saying EG's going to win. What role do you mean?
So I was actually a GM support player one time.
I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, I know. I was number one Braum NA. I've got no hands, so.
Speaking of Braum, have you heard of my Braum?
Yeah, dude, your Braum's sick.
Have you heard of the famous story about my Braum?
No, I have not.
MSI Joey Braum?
Okay, yeah. Now I
remember. That's two. We're keeping track. We're making a count of how many times I can mention MSI.
There you go. I mean, that's good, right?
Yeah.
You just throw on the TL gear like it's no one's business, then you're good to go.
How do you think NA is going to do this year at MSI?
Honestly, I was watching LPL finals a bit this morning. I think that, like, MSI could be open. Like, I think T1's overrated. The only thing that I, like, am worried about when it comes to NA teams going is that I'm worried about mid-jungle. I think that if you look at what every team, like, the regions are sending, the mid jungles are just insane from like every single team. So I'm kind of worried about NA if it's not 100 or EG. And I think that EG is actually the best mid jungle that we have at the moment. So yeah.
I've been a fan of JoJo since he came into Academy, and I want to push domestic talent forward. So, you know, and Bjergsen's a go. So.
It's been really cool seeing the success of both JoJo and Danny, I would say, coming up from the Academy systems and amateur systems. Like,
that's been on the same team. It's awesome.
it's nice to see EG doing it like that. No one else is doing it like that in their top three, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I had one other question, but I can't think of it. So.
It's all good.
Oh, NA or EU at MSI. Who's going to do better? Because it doesn't sound like you're very confident
NA.
In NA.
NA!
NA! NA! NA! NA! NA! NA!
Hey, guys, you're here at Houston LCS Finals. I have the head coach of Immortals Academy here. All right, thank you for the take. So,
and then you have Freeze.
And then I have Freeze on my right. Okay. So, how are you enjoying the live event so far?
So far, so good. I don't like the Houston weather, but it is what it is.
Wow, we're that picky. We go to California for 1 year, and we just can't complain about weather. All right. So, big match today: 100 Thieves versus EG. Who do you think is gonna win?
EG are actually pretty good, so I feel like it will go all the way. five games, and I mean, I wish we, like, 100 Thieves can win, but it can even go easy way.
Why do you want 100 Thieves to win?
I'm a big fan.
Why is that? Do you know that 100 Thieves has a coach who looks very close and similar to you?
Oh, really? Okay.
Have you noticed?
No.
Oh. Do you think NA is going to do better than EU this year at MSI?
No.
Have you seen the groups?
No.
MSI, or EU is playing NA in groups twice.
It's doomed. It's doomed. NA.
For who? EU?
No, NA.
Are you sure it's not doomed for EU?
No.
You know you're in North America, right?
Yeah, and I don't care.
You should be supporting the local culture.
Nah.
Well, that's a little toxic. I wish you'd be a little bit more happy with how NA has performed this year. I thought we're doing great. Hopefully we'll send some nice two good rookies, and thanks for the interview. Appreciate it. With Kangas, a notable caster from Academy. Is this your first finals event?
This is, actually. I've never been at a live one before, so I'm really pumped.
How are you liking it so far?
It's busy. There's a lot of people. I wanted to get a hot dog, but it's like a 30-minute wait, so we'll wait.
That's a bit unfortunate on the hot dog situation. Who do you think is going to win finals?
I'm rooting EG.
Are you concerned that they're not in any of the content involved? They're being kind of foreshadowed as the loser already.
What the hell, Riot? Why is Danny on the tiny little corner of the t-shirt? Have you gotten the t-shirt yet?
No, I have not gotten the t-shirt. But I've seen the t-shirt, and I'm a little upset with Riot, too. They're doing my boy Danny pretty dirty.
I want to get Blabber and Fudge to sign it, just as a meme.
That's a little mean. All right. Well, thank you for your time. Anything you want to say to the fans?
Cheer on, cheer loud, and EG, ooh-ha-ha.